Have you ever wanted to change the default render export settings inside After Effects? Well, in this video, I'm gonna show you how to do that and create some custom options for you. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
All right, so I'm inside Adobe After Effects and I have a project open. And just to show you the thing that we're gonna be changing, say if I render this out and want to add it to the render queue, you'll notice that the default at the bottom left is H.264 match render settings, 15 megabits per second. Say if you wanted to change this default setting to be something else, you can do that. Maybe you want Apple ProRes or a different video codec, you can easily change this setting. So to change this, click on the text next to output module, and then you can change your format options. So from the dropdown, say if we wanted to do Apple ProRes, we can change it to QuickTime. And then from the format options, we can choose maybe Apple ProRes HQ. Say if we typically want to render out our compositions inside this video codec, we can choose that as the default, click OK, and then click OK. Now you'll notice that it changes to custom QuickTime, but to set this as your default, what you can do is click on this dropdown and click Make Template. This will make it as a template so these settings are saved. So I'm gonna name it Apple ProRes 422 HQ, and then just click OK. And as you can see, it updates here. Now we can set this as the default by clicking on the dropdown, and you can see that auto-populates there. And what you can do is hold down Command or Control on a PC, and then click on that option. You'll notice in the info panel that will be set for the default output module. And just to illustrate, say if I remove this from the render queue and I go back into a composition and I add this to the render queue once again, add the render queue, you can see that that's now the default. Now this is great just to change the default output module, but say if you wanted to create a bunch of templates, I'm gonna show you another way to do this. So if you go up to Edit, Templates, Output Module, you'll see the output module templates screen pop up again. You can create a bunch of different templates as well as change some of the other settings as well. For example, maybe we like Apple ProRes 422 HQ, but we want to create a proxy one. Maybe we want to create one with an alpha channel and a few different options that we can select inside the export window to render out our compositions in different ways. So for example, to create another template, we can click this new button and say if we wanted to create an Apple ProRes that supports an alpha channel, we can go to format options and change this to Apple ProRes 4444 and then click OK, and then change the channels from RGB to RGB plus alpha and then click OK. And then you can name this new setting. So I'm gonna name it Apple ProRes 4444 with alpha. That way we know that that has an alpha channel. And now when we click this dropdown, you'll notice that that's added here at the bottom, Apple ProRes 4444 with alpha. I also like changing this default frame option from Photoshop. A lot of times I just want to export either a JPEG or a PNG if I'm exporting a still frame out of After Effects. So to create a still frame one, we can click new. And then from the format dropdown, we can go to PNG sequence. I just make sure that RGB plus alpha is selected and then click OK. And we can just name this PNG sequence. And then from the dropdown next to frame default, we can change this to PNG sequence. You can add as many as you like, but that's the overall process to save render presets and templates inside Adobe After Effects. So that's how to save render presets inside Adobe After Effects. If you have any questions, be sure to reach out in the comments section below. But otherwise, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you guys in the next tutorial.